fit in.
This man, shout out to Gutter. Never fit in. Shout out to Gutter, man. Austin, Texas. Hey. For helping me, you know, be outside the box when it came to music. Like, I was taught from somebody like Philly, Jersey, New York type people. That's how I learned how to rap. It was about bars first. Yeah, that's definitely the motto. It's like, you know, nigga don't need no handouts and show not trying to be regular. So, what else is there? And then it's like, you wake up. A lot of people like to spend time with their family. A lot of people like to be involved with other people. And it's just like, once you go to prison, for real, you sitting in prison, and it's like, luckily I had took care of a lot of people in the free world before I went. And then when I went, I was seeing like how nobody, certain people was like, a lot of people was like not getting no mail, no money on their books. I was getting money on my books so much to where it was to the point to where I just started saving it. It was becoming so much from so many different people because I had shown so much love. And it was the exact opposite. And it was just like, the people told me in there, they're like, you know what I'm saying? You was really somebody. You really took care of niggas. And they sure taking care of you in this whole mail call. Steward for mail every single day. I got mail every day for damn near 2 years. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, it's just all about who you are deep down, and then, you know, like, at the end of the day, it's gonna reveal itself. If you really about something, it's gonna show. It may not show right now, or it may shimmer a little bit right now, but, you know, see where you at in a year or two, you know what I'm saying? I ain't stopped since I started. I'm one of them ones that's been in trouble since the beginning, and it's just like, I just grew out of it. You know what I mean? I was one of the ones, I've been on probation since I was 14, 15 years old, and didn't get off until I was like 28. So I was on papers for so long throughout my life to where it just got to the point to where it's just like, I figured it out.
I had got it out.
It was kind of... It's kind of amazing because there was the DNS family meeting at the same time, so it was like 1,000 people pulled up for the party when I got out in Austin. And it was just really, you know, life-changing just seeing that many people pull up for you. And after that, I was like, shit, I can't stop. Yeah, I had wrote like four CDs. Yeah. And then it's like, my thing too is like, don't just produce a bunch of music. Produce a bunch of hits, you know what I mean? Like, put quality into the hustle of whatever it is that you can do. Food is weak, half of the women is weak. It's like, you know, we gotta get it together overall. So, I just rather deal with the quality side of things than everything I deal with, you know what I'm saying? So, what I have, I think it's a lot of freedom because I don't trust nobody. And two, it's like, before problems can be created, it's like, I'd rather avoid them, you know what I'm saying? So really, I think it was just a blessing for me and my people, because it's like, we make all our own money, our own music, our own beats, you know, our own videos. It's all an in-house situation, so I just feel like the money should be too, and you know what I'm saying, like a big enough platform to where when you release, you can really find it, you know what I'm saying? Like, I see different things popping up in Google for me already. And it's just, you know, a whole different situation when you're dealing with the big leagues. So we definitely coming with it. In the back, in the very back, I'm doing a studio. We're coming upstairs, downstairs in the back. In the middle right here, I'm gonna do a lounge. That's why I already started pulling the little couches in and stuff right now, because this is gonna be blocked off from the front where it'll be a clothing store. And it's just like, you know, it ain't no stress. I'm doing it at my pace. I already got the vision for it. I didn't pay for anything already. So it's just like, you know, I envisioned it, I wanted it, and now I got it. It didn't take a week or two, you know what I mean?
Right.
Never fit in.
Right.
So yeah, and that's just to basically, I already had a spot in Hollywood, but it was always so crowded, and you know, things was expanding a little better. So I feel like making enough room for everybody. And then if you got too much room, think up some new hustles to do all of the same hustling off under the same building, under the same roof. Yeah, make all the space make sense.
Well, better just, you know, get some space and put people to work.
Yeah, because it's like a shit, if you're scared money don't make no money, and if you don't try nothing, you're never going to exceed whatever it is that you're used to. You know what I'm saying? Whatever is already going down, you're never going to pass that if you don't try to take shit to the next level, obviously. You know, it fueled me to a level to where I just got used to it. I got used to working hard. I got used to always wanting more for myself, my surroundings, my family, my people, my friends, my females, all of them. You know what I'm saying? I had that much hustle to where I could get enough for everybody too. You know what I'm saying? So I just feel like after a while of just wanting more for yourself, and if it just becomes a habit, you then grow into a new person to where you just all hustle. You know what I mean? And then you get to the point to where you have to fight for your own freedom for yourself to be able to go and enjoy yourself and eat right and do the things that you need to do, because you be hustling so hard you forget to even take care of yourself. You know what I'm saying? So it's just a way of life. You know what I mean? Like either you hustle all day or you don't. I never fit in, I was at the paper. First thing impressed me was a Glock and a Jacob. I'm not a rapper out here capping and faking. Pull a foreign up in person, I ain't flexing how I'm making. She can't fuck me unless she bringing home the bacon. Beat made by Sicc, baby mama's out there shaking. We didn't come to trip the whips out there Lakers. I'm a smooth criminal, swung a Porsche making. It's King Sicglicious, I'm out the paper. I'm out there hitting bad bitches on the daily. Pop bottles everywhere, my soul's hit the pavement. Shorty wanna ski, baby, and she wanna taste it. I trap hard, so she let me get a facial. All I really wanted was some throat and some paces. Real Texas nigga got a foe in the face.